Next thing I'm going to do is display the footer menus. So let's say over here, say footer menus, and then a div here. And inside of this div, I'm going to say if not is empty. So let's pull the is empty on top, is empty from Lodash. So if not is empty, footer menu items, and is array, footer menu items. Again, we have to pull the is array on top from Lodash. So if it's an array, if it's not empty, then in that case, I want to loop through this footer menu items. So footer menu items. In fact, before even I loop through it, let's put a UL tag, shall we? Yep, because it should be list items. And then inside of this, I'll say footer menu items dot map footer menu. And inside of this, we'll say li. And this should have a key. Okay, and then inside of this li, we should have a link tag. So let's import link tag. Import link from next link. Yep, this will be link. There will be an href, which we will add in a moment. We will also add a key over here. So I'll come back to this in a moment. And then inside of this, there'll be an a tag. And inside of a tag, we will have the menu items. Let's put hello for now. Let's see what we have available inside of the footer menu. So inside of the footer menu items, first we have the ID. We also have the URL, which is great. So let's do that. So key will be footer menu dot ID. Let's do that. Ideally, it should be called menu item in my opinion. Yeah, menu item dot ID. And then we need title and URL. So menu item dot title, and this will be the URL. So menu item dot URL. Okay, let's see how that goes. Perfect. We have the kids, women, and categories. So let's take a look. There you go. So that's your UL, LI. We have kids, and then we've got the women. So if you go back and check under the footer menus, the menus, footer menu, you've got kids, women, and categories. And that's what we have on the front end, which is perfect, which is great. So we've got our menu items. The next thing we need to do is add the copyright text. So for that, I'm going to say, put that there. And okay, inside of this, I'm going to put another div. And then there'll be one more where we're going to put the social menu items. Okay, so in the first one, we're going to put the copyright text, all right? So this will be my copyright text. So where is that available? It's available here, correct? So I'm going to say copyright text. If it's available, great. Let's print that. If not, then I'm going to say copyright 2021. Okay. Now let's take a look. How is that looking? Which is great. Quoted Academy 2021. Why? Because if I check my copyright text, footer, it's Quoted Tech Academy 2021. That's why it's showing that. All right. And you also have the fallback for that. Now we need the social link. So again, for the social link, if you check, we have the social link inside of this property. So let's do that. So I'll come over here. Again, same thing. I'll say is not is empty. Social links. If it's not empty and is array, social links, then else null. Now inside of this, we'll say UL. We'll give it a class, flex item center. Notice that we didn't have to write any CSS apart from adding the classes, which is pretty powerful if you ask me. Then if that's so, then we're going to loop through it. So we'll say social links dot map, and we'll say social link. And inside of this, there'll be a list item, and we're going to loop through it. Now, this is going to need a key. I'll just put hello for now. So what do we have here? So we have an icon name, and I'm pretty sure that this is going to be constant. So let's just use the icon name as the key. Icon name, social link dot icon name. So optional chaining, social link dot icon name. And let's give it a class of ML4. Margin left 4. And then inside of this, so I need an a tag. Remember over here, we don't need the link tag because social links are going to be external. So this is not an internal link, so we don't have to use the link tag. All right. So inside of this, I basically, what I need to do is span name of that icon. So this is for screen readers, by the way, because for users, we're going to show the icon, but for screen readers, for accessibility, we're going to use the screen reader text. I think the class name is screen reader text, but I'm going to double check that. So let's check screen readers. Oh, it's SR only. Okay. So let's put SR only. It's great. So now if you go back, you'll notice that it's gone. It's there. It's just that it's going to be there for screen readers, not for the users. It's going to be hidden. So notice that you have that, but you have position absolute and width height or whatever it needs to be. Okay, that's good for accessibility. Next thing you want to do is basically display the icons and the URL. So let's go with the URL first. So what do we have? Where do we have the URL available? Let's see. We have that available in icon URL, right? So I'm going to say social link dot icon URL, else I'm just going to say empty, just in case if it's empty, then just put the root. Okay. How do I ensure that I get the icons dynamically? I don't want to repeat these link items four times because we are looping through, right? So for this reason, we are going to get the components. So if you remember from the previous video, we created the icons component for each one of those, which was Instagram, Twitter, YouTube, Facebook, and things like that. Now, this is available for you to import, but I want to be able to import these based on the name. So if I can get a function, if I can have a function that allows me to just pass the icon name and then give me the right kind of icon component, I think that does the job, right? So if I pass Facebook, then I should be able to get this Facebook SVG icon component, right? So how do we do that? So I'm going to write that function. So I'll go to utils and then I'm going to create a file called icon map, icons map.js. Okay. And over here, so it's going to import all of the SVG components from the index, which is this. It's going to import all of that as all. And then this function get icon component by name is going to take the name of the component. And then we are creating a constant. We're saying that if the name is actually Facebook, then render the, basically get the SVG icons component Facebook, which means this one. Okay. If it is Twitter, if the value of the name is Twitter, then we're going to provide Twitter component, this one, which is the SVG component. And that's what we're doing over here. Basically saying, if whatever name is passed, if that is available inside this object as a key, then the icon component will be equal to component map and the name. So if I pass Facebook in the parameter over here, then it's going to say, okay, component map, get me the value of the property Facebook. So value of the property Facebook is SVG component Facebook. So this is going to be the value of that. So this will become equal to SVG icons component.facebook. That's what will be returned. Okay. If we pass Twitter here in the name, then it's going to say, okay, so components map, this will become Twitter over here. This will become Twitter. And then it's going to ensure it makes it equal to Twitter. So that's pretty useful. And tomorrow, if you have more components, you can map it accordingly. So that's really good. Okay, so it's going to return that component. And if it's not there within this list, then it's just going to return null. So with that, makes my job easier. I can go over here and I can just say, get component by name and then pass the icon name, right? And make sure to import this function on top. So let's do that. Let's say import from utils, icons map, and that's it. Let's make it internal dependencies. And this will be now, if you go back and check, there you go. Congratulations, you've got your icons. And then if you click on one of these icons, let's take a look. You can see that you've got the right SVG being outputted. You've got the right link. And that's the link actually coming from the social links that you put in the WordPress. And this is great because then I can control the value of these for ourselves. The next thing you need to do is ensure that this is target blank, because it's supposed to open in the new window. It's an external link. And then also For accessibility, you can also give this a title. The link can have a title attribute. So just say title. Okay. So title, social link, icon name. Awesome. Perfect. All right then. Okay. And we should also wrap it inside of a container so that it's the same width as the main header. So let's ensure we do that. So what do we have on the header? So header, container. So we have a container and we have MX auto. So let's do that. So I'm going to go to the footer. I'll wrap this into a container. So I'll say div and class container MX auto. Let's try that. Awesome. Perfect. So now the width of the content, of course, is the same as the header. We'll fix the main content where you're seeing the welcome to Next.js and hello and stuff later on. But you get the idea. You've got the footer working great. You've got the widgets and stuff. You've got the copyright text. And of course, you can make it look more beautiful with all your CSS skills. But this tutorial is mainly to focus on how to create the website than to focus just on CSS. All right? Perfect. So I hope you did like the video. If you did, please give a thumbs up and do subscribe to my channel if you aren't already. Do follow me on GitHub. My GitHub handle is ImranHSayed. And please start my repository to support my work. And please do follow me on Twitter as well. My Twitter handle is CodyTech. All right. I'm going to see you in the next video. Thank you very much. Bye-bye.